Hello, I'm Liao. So SvelteKit is an application framework that allows you to build Svelte application that is optimized. It allows you to do client-side rendering, server-side rendering, optimization such as prefetching, hydration, and a lot of things. I know if you are new to building web front-end application using modern stack, words like client-side rendering or server-side rendering and a lot of things that I just said may be very foreign to you. So I dedicated a few videos and the following videos and the current one and the following ones to talk about these concepts. Try to explain it in a beginner level, try to use plain English, easy to understand words to explain what they actually means. Because a lot of times after people using them for a while, it sounded like buzzwords, saying out loud but may not really fully grasp what it actually means. So in this video, I'm going to talk about client-side rendering and server-side rendering. Meaning, what is client-side rendering and server-side rendering? Well, let's take a look. If you learn about web, building web application, the first thing you learn about is HTML, right? You learn about how to write HTML, which allows you to write the structure and the layout of your website. So this piece of code over here that you just write will probably look like this on the browser, right? Fairly easy, very straightforward. You have a heading, one and two, and you have a div and some anchor tags for links, and this will look like this on the right. So this site, sometimes we call it a static site because it looks very static. When I say static, it means that the content of the website doesn't really change based on user inputs. I don't have, and when I say dynamic, which means the site's contents have user-generated content, right? Dynamically generated by users. Like YouTube, right? If you visit YouTube, this is one of my videos, you get probably the same layout for each videos, but the content is very dynamic, right? You have different title, you have different YouTuber, you have different content, you have different recommendations, and they are very dynamic. Every time when you visit, it's different, right? So the HTML for this page may look like this for this video, and may look different like this for another video. So when we create a website like this, usually we come up with a template that looks like this, right? We have the structure, the HTML structure, but we have place where we are dynamic based on different content, based on different data. So usually we have data, we add the data with the template that comes, that turns it into the final HTML that you see just now, right? And different data may end up different HTML. And this process of combining like the data and maybe a bit of a template to generate the final HTML that you see is called rendering. And the word renders has a lot of meanings. And the one that I like the most that describes this process the most accurate, I would say, is the definition that is being used for art. Render means represent or depict or to draw. So in web development, the browser draws out the website based on the HTML that we developer provides. And we developer use a template and the data to generate the HTML to describe how we want the browser to draw on the screen based on the HTML. Right? And the rendering process can happen in two places, server-side, client-side. But before we jump into that, let's take a step back and take a look at how browser receives the HTML from the developer. When you open your browser, key in a URL like youtube.com, what happens is that YouTube will be used as an address to look for the server or the computer that serves the YouTube website. And what it returns is a content. So the server responds the request with the contents for the YouTube website. And what that content is actually a blob of text, characters, strings, right? Just text that contains a certain structure, schema, or grammar. And this piece of content that follows this structure, we often call it HTML, We name this content based on the structure itself. So this structure is called the HTML, the Hypertext Markup Language. So the browser receives the HTML, reads it, and draws based on the representation of the HTML on the screen, right? So you have a video tag in the HTML, then the browser will draw a video element on the screen and you see the video content. You don't have to know all the details on how the browser converts the HTML, the string, HTML content into things that you see on the screen. But one thing you must know, which is the browser read this piece of text, right? This is just text. And it converts it into an internal model within the browser itself called the Document Object Model, or DOM for short. And it uses this DOM to actually do like layout, calculation, and eventually based on this DOM, this object model, it draws the content out onto the screen where you see like this. So why is knowing DOM important? Well, that's because the browser also provides you the DOM API to allow you to programmatically create, modify, remove certain elements from the DOM. Basically, modify the DOM itself. So you have this API that looks like this, right? Append children, create elements, insert before, remove child, and things like that. So let's recap. So after the browser receives the HTML, it creates a DOM and draws the content out of the screen. And you still can modify how the content looks like by basically using the DOM API and to run your JavaScript code to basically modify the DOM and modify how it looks like on the browser. So basically here, you see there's two places that we can run code that will eventually determine how the DOM looks like and eventually determines how the content looks like on the screen. So both places can come up with equally rich and complex DOM structure. So in this regard, there's no one place that is better than another. As you can see, one runs on the server, call it the server side, and one runs on the browser, and sometimes you call the client, so it's on the client side. To render content in the server side, takes in data and generate HTML string. They'll eventually receive by the browser being passed to the DOM and displayed on the screen, right? So the route from the server side is to generate this, to have a function that generates a HTML string that eventually converts to the DOM by the browser. On the other hand, on the client side, takes in data and use browser DOM API to modify the DOM directly, right? So it does not go through like HTML. It modifies the DOM directly. And the browser then display based on the DOM on the screen. So most modern frameworks provide you a way to do server-side rendering and client-side rendering. And Svelte does that too. Which means Svelte, like all these frameworks that you see over here, allows you to write code once, something like this, and eventually provides you an API to generate HTML for server-side rendering or modify the DOM for client-side rendering. And there you have it. Client-side rendering and server-side rendering, right? It's just code that runs on different side, on the server side and client side, that eventually determines how the DOM structure looks like and how you see on the screen. And that's it for this video. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And you have any questions, feel free to comment in the comment section below. And we'll see you in the next video where we're going to talk about hydration. Bye.